Yeah, so you've been real critical of celebrities, right? But someone you do seem to have a little bit of a soft spot for is your boy 50 Cent, okay? 50's been on Diddy's head, pause, no Diddy, with nonstop posts. Why do you think 50 hates Diddy so much?
That's a good question. I'm trying to remember, because I know I heard some stuff about like how far back their beef went. I don't know exactly why. I don't know.
Some of the possible things, right? It's like, for example, Diddy had the opportunity to sign 50 before 50 ever blew up, but he used them just as a ghostwriter. That was one situation. There was a situation where 50 wanted to sign Mace, right, from Diddy. And Diddy was like, yeah, we'll do the deal. We'll do the yada, yada. And then like he kept like prolonging it. And then he said, no, I want $2 million for Mace. And 50 was like, Mace is not even worth $2 million with $2 million in his pocket. You know what I mean? And so, and then he ended up dissing Diddy on a song, but they've worked together over the years too, you know? So it's been an interesting back and forth. But if you notice, as soon as Diddy started to have a fall with the whole Keefe D allegations and everything, the Tupac murder and stuff, it's like 50's been nonstop. Like Diddy hasn't had a good 2 years. Like he's like, you know, keeps on.
Yeah. Yeah, like all the inside stuff and him being overlooked and 50 is a cancer. You know, they're going to come back and they're going to troll. You know what I mean? Like, I get that energy. Like, I'll troll people for the rest of their lives who did me wrong. Like, that's just, just a little exposing myself. But I'm also thinking, you're so bold, Fifth, to like come out like this and to like, because you're in the industry too. But at the same time, he's probably getting a little ego thinking that his stuff can't, you know, get exposed at the same time because you're on, you know what I mean? So you've been portal holding too, fool.
Wait. No. Portal holding, that you just created a whole new term. Oh my God, man. The fans are going to go crazy over this. Wow. Okay. Well, in the Lil Rod lawsuit, right? It says Diddy used Young Miami, who, you know, we saw him be in somewhat of a relationship with, right? And 50's baby mama, Daphne Joy, who we've seen pictures of Diddy holding hands with her in the past. They're saying that he used them as sex workers.
I saw this the other day. I was like, yo, did Diddy send Daphne to 50?
No, I don't think it's that. I think if it did happen, it happened after Diddy 50's relationship with her, you know, but
okay, sorry, what was your question again? Ask that again.
No, I'm saying that like in this new lawsuit, right, by Lil Rod, he's saying that these two people who we've seen around Diddy are actually being used by Diddy as alleged sex workers. Now, someone as famous and successful as Diddy has plenty of choices. You know, plenty of choices of women to choose from, right? Why he got to choose 50's baby mama? So that might be some insight into why 50 hates him so much.
I don't know exactly, you know. But I do know to tap in, like, so, okay, keep in mind. Within the industry, there are specific sex workers. And I want to talk about this shit because this needs to be fucking exposed right now, right? So, okay, let's go back to King Louis XIV, right? Like the back in those times where in France, prostitution was outlawed at one point. But Louis XIV was such he was such a horn dog that he decided to bring back in prostitution. He caught a venereal disease. He got pissed off, so he outlawed it again to the public. Decided to create his own elitist brothels. So these houses, you know what I mean, of people, of his own prostitutes that were not, didn't, you know, they didn't philander anywhere else. That translates over into today. All these specific elitist type prostitutes that are in position. So it's like, they have to be used because they're in that position. You know what I mean? You can't go just get a regular prostitute that's not under this hierarchy and ranking. You know what I mean? There's like, there's ranking within the industry. And there's this girl in New York City, this Dominican chick, that was living in Harlem. When I met her at a friend of mine who is, his name is Uncut Art. He does, if you've ever seen Protect Your Heart on the Street. So I met her at this event and she told me she was a school teacher, right? And I was with another friend, another artist friend at the time. So we had connected with her separately. She invited me out to some party, some pool party in Jersey, right? When I get to the pool party, I'm realizing, yo, all these pretty girls show up, you know what I mean? Like bad bitches. I'm like, yo, this is a fucking escort service. And
wait, what made you realize that it was an escort service?
I picked up on the energy. You know what I mean? When you're intuitive, you just know. And I'm just like, and then I was like, I got to get the fuck out of here. So maneuvered, got out or whatever. And then I talked to my other friend who had met her too. And he was like, it's funny. He's like, she told me, she was like, yeah, I run an escort service. And then she was like, oh, I'm just kidding. But then she told me she was a school teacher. Now, for a year and a half, she was hitting me up. Oh, hey, baby, come out to the Hamptons for the weekend. Everything's paid for. Oh, hey, baby, come to the Philip Pline Fashion Show. I have front row tickets. I dubbed her for a year and a half. I let her just like converse with me and I'm like, yo, she's making money. She's running a whole operation. And so I just ended up cutting her off or whatever. Next thing you know, I'm seeing her pop up within friends of mine. Cootie's following her. Another friend, a bunch of industry people in New York are following her. She's at the UN. She's now an author. Billboard magazine did a whole write up on her. Wow. She's a madam. And this is what happens is you see all these PR people all like, you know, and that coming up in the industry, they actually are a part of big sex trafficking rings. And like I said, there are specific prostitutes. When models walk the runway, they're being auctioned off. You know what I mean? All of these fashion houses were just the elitist brothels from back in the day. Which is why it's linked to all the sex trafficking and the child trafficking. And then it gets deeper. And then these people, it's not only just they were having sex and opening portals, but now they're murdering children and drinking blood to gain higher levels of spirituality.
That's crazy.
Sorry.
No. That's fine. Because, you know, in our first interview, you had spoken about, you know, the guy that you used to date, Dre. He had ran into some women that were allegedly.
No, I never dated Dre. You're talking about the basketball player, right?
Yeah. Or was your friend?
I never dated him. He was a friend. Yes.
Okay. Right. And he had ran into some women that ended up being escorts, right? Within the industry.
All the models. I realized that all the models that I was on in the 50 shoot with were also like girls that were being pimped out in the industry.
Wow. Yeah.
And I was like, I got to stop hanging out with these people because I don't want to be guilty by association. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just not that type of girl. Not that type of girl. Mm-hmm. I don't care if we're in VIP getting free bottles and free. Like, nope. That is not me.
Definitely not willing to sell your soul just for some of that. Right.
Like, crazy.
Yeah.